Job 14:1-4, a man that's born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. Trouble comes on every side. It seems like that you can't get nothing right. You take one step forward, you get not two steps backwards. We pray and pray all night long, seeing that our prayers are being unanswered. We've given all that we have given. We've taken all that we can take. I want you to understand something. As it says in Romans 8:28, all things work together for the good of them that love God and are called according to His purpose. There's a purpose that God has for you, a destiny that God wants you to reach. And it's up for us to find out what that purpose and destiny is. We've searched for things in our life. We've looked for love in the wrong places. We try to fill with these things, look for purpose, as some may call it. We try this and we try that. But when are we going to try God? When are we going to try the one who sent his only begotten Son, who hung, who bled, who died for us, who on that third day rose with all power in his hands? Why can't we trust a God that has all power in his hands? He has an all-seeing eye. He knows all. He is all. And as a very present help in time of need, why can't we put our trust in a God that loves us? He loves us so much, with his arms stretched wide, waiting on us to come to him. But yet still, we try to do our own thing. We try to be big and bad enough to do what we want to do. Think that we have time to come to him. No man knows the day or the hour, but the Son of Man shall come. No man knows. There was a guy on the radio who declared that he knew time when that day was going to come. I believe he's gone on now, if I'm not mistaken. For he knew the exact day. He went against God's word that no man knows the day nor the hour. Have you ever felt like nothing good ever happens to you? That somebody else is getting blessed the way you need to be blessed? Have you ever said to yourself, why can't God bless me? I've got some news for you. That the feelings of isolation, loneliness, and abandonment that you face are nothing that the enemy is trying to bring you down. We just looked at some very powerful words from the scripture that simply says that God be for us. Who can be against us? I believe that God wants to minister to us this morning. Some of you are wounded, broken. You are desperately in need to God to heal your heart and your emotions. Satan has trampled you all week long. You've come in with a smile painted on your face. But deep down inside, you are tore up from the floor. Your face is showing, or is trying to show, what you've been through. The hell that you've had in the past week. The torment that you have endured through the last week. The bad news you have gotten during the last week. All these things, the Bible says, the trials come to make us strong. We have to be patient during this race, y'all. We have to be patient. Run with patience. We can't have that microwave mentality. We want things quick and in a hurry. I've heard it said that good things come to those that wait. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage, the Bible says. And he will strengthen thine heart. We perpetuate an attitude and we say, if you don't do it right now, God, it's never going to be done. We've had in our minds that God is this authoritative God, which is true. But if we only think that he has that great authority and that we fear him, how do we come to him? We serve a God who is strong in might, but shows grace all at the same time. He has a hand right over for you to come to him. When you're going through things, call on God. You have to call on God, the one who sits high and he looks up. Call on God while he's yet to be found. We can't wait too late. Time is winding up. Time is winding up. There's things that's going on. Things that are showing up. How God is going to show himself mighty, that he is God. And that he's not playing. He's given us enough time to get it right. Get it right now. While the blood is running warm in your veins. Because once you get up here, it's too late. It's too late. So get it right. Right now, I got 3 points we have to wait. First, in order for us to understand that God is on our side, we must first understand our relationship with him. This is a critical point of our lives. This is where we mess up because we don't understand our relationship with God. We're like Israel so many times. Israel could not get it right. They saw God as the lawgiver, an authority figure that they were afraid of. They knew him as the one on top of Mount Sinai where the thunder of lightning was. And if you didn't do something that God didn't like, you were toast. They let Moses go up the mountain while they told him they were content where they were. They were afraid of God because of the way they missed out on the relationship that God wanted with them. If we only see God as an authority figure, then we really miss out on what God is all about. Let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. He didn't give us 10 commandments just so we can have a bunch of rules to follow. God knew that there were certain things that would happen in our lives if we knew them. The 10 commandments were more than just laws written down. There were 10 areas that God wanted his people to know. That if we live by these laws, it will open up a very new dimension of our relationship with him. In essence, they were an expression of love. For example, you don't stop loving your children because you correct them, because you discipline them. You don't stop whooping your kids because you think that they're going to cause them to resent. But what we do is, we do it out of love. We do it out of love. Correction. If a child is going a bad way, you direct them now so they can turn from that way. We have to understand that God loves us, and He wants us to have a better relationship with Him. He loves us that much, even the ones who are in hell. He loves them. But because of their own intentions, their self-satisfaction, He gives them a chance. But they turn their back on God. Salvation is about accepting God, His invitation to let Him love us. Salvation is the ultimate expression of love. To think that God was willing to make us as He was, with all our faults, all of our failings, there was nothing that I could hide from Him, and yet He was willing to make me out to be something that I thought I could be. Lord, help me to see what it is that You see through Your eyes, because through my eyes, truth be told, I don't see it happening. But I'm so glad that we live by faith and not by sight. For faith is something of things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen. These eyes and this is a whole lot of struggles. A whole lot of struggles. What you see, it always live for you. What you hear, it always live for you. What you lay your hands on, it always live for you. Whatever you walk in, it always live for you. We have to guard our gates. What we see, what we hear, what we taste, what we smell, what we put our hands on. Because we know we'll be led on flesh and not by the Spirit. Lord, help me be full of the Spirit. Because being full of the Spirit, there's no room for anything else. Tell me you're full of the Spirit. If God be for us, who can be against us? The challenges of life come at us every day. Decisions that we make during the course of a week can be very challenging. Sometimes the decisions that we make are desperate decisions. Sometimes we make decisions without the counsel of an Almighty God. Without going to the one who knows the outcome before it even happens. The one who sits out and looks low. Who has an all-seeing eye. The creator of heaven and earth. The earth the Lord is full of them, and they dwell with Him. God knows what's going to happen before it even happens. He knows the number of strands in your head. Oh, Lord, look, I have none, but the strands in your head. No, never. The other strands up here come very long and they're up there. But He knows my name. He knows that what I hope for is going to make me strong. How many of you go to the gym? I'm supposed to go to the gym, put that way. That's me. We know if we feel the weight image and we lift some weights, we need to get a little stronger. If we do it, made right. Some of those young fellas stay the same side, and I felt like I'm getting real life, if you will. So trial comes to make us strong. Now be careful when you ask for God to give you strength. Be careful when you ask for God to give you strength. Because what I said earlier, trials come to make us strong. So those trials are coming to make us strong. But also pay for endurance to make you strong. The storm of life is raging. And there's a lot of people getting caught up in these storms and don't understand that it's keep moving forward. The storm will pass. If they keep moving forward, the storm will pass over. You just can't sit still in the storm. The Bible tells that yea, you are walking through a valley of the shadow of death. You gotta walk through. Because I feel no evil. Why? Because God is with me. He's on my side. And no matter what I go through, God is right there. No matter the situations I face, God is right there. The bills are due, God is right there. When my money is acting funny, when my change is acting strange, God is right there. Hallelujah. So many times. And it seems like you've been overlooked. God is on your side. See, you've been, it's only been delayed, but not denied. God will take care of you.
Yes, sir.
God will see you through.
Yes, sir.
God will take care of you. He'll take care of you. No matter what you go through. Life. God will take care of you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. He will be there to the end of the world. Who would serve a God like this? Who would serve a God like this? It seems like it's over. Your back is against the wall. You can't see how you're going to get out of the situation. When you call on Jesus, he will answer prayer. When you call on the Lord, he will always be there. He was on that old way cross. Now my Savior, he hung and bled and died.
Yes, sir.
But on that third day, he rose to the fire.
Yes, sir.
In his hand. Who's on the Lord's side? fue para afuera.